Listen to Bridges, welcome to the Geek Chest. My name's Steve.
My name is Arnes.
And it's my birthday today. It's Friday. Granted, we're filming this on Thursday, so it's not actually my birthday, but when this comes out, it'll be my birthday. And Arnes has a present for me.
No, I don't.
Or at least I'm assuming. What's in the Amazon box?
Steve says he wanted a diorama. I thought he said diarrhea, so...
It's a present. I'm cool.
Misunderstanding, it happens.
It's just a box full of poop. Fine. Can I open it?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sweet.
Told you, box full
garbage.
Of
garbage.
Told you, box full of poop, man.
Well, it's something I've been getting bugged at a while for a while to do a review on the channel with, so that's cool. So what we have is the SH Monster with Gigan. It's the only one I was really missing.
Told you, yay. Box full of poop.
Is it used?
No.
Is it used? Do I get to complain? Looks like everything's closed.
No, he came from the Amazon thing.
Oh, cool. Sweet. Well, I got a review to do today. Try to have this guy up sometime soon. Oh, sorry. I gotta put Unit Zero out and then... Probably work on this guy next.
And we gotta do Woody and...
There's a lot. I still got the video game one I gotta do too. Anyways, we're getting distracted from what you guys are probably actually here for, is the review of Godzilla and Mothra Battle for Earth.
Can we talk about that?
I'll give you that one.
I think it'll be a better investment in our time and their time.
Nah, we gotta talk about the movie. It's Mothra. Everyone loves Mothra. Because this is an environmental movie. If you guys haven't seen it, pretty much the premise is, meteor hits the Earth, causes typhoons, starts wreaking havoc on the weather. Also, we've been wreaking havoc on our weather, too, because of pollution, yada, yada, yada. So, because the meteor hits, Godzilla wakes up because of the pollution, Bachelor wakes up, and because of the typhoons, Mothra gets unleashed. There seems to be a lot of coincidences happening at one time.
Too many. Too many.
So, then we get people trying to get the Mothra egg for themselves for an investment. Heard that one before. Godzilla's just doing what Godzilla does, and Bachelor wants to kill us all.
That all may sound like fun. And a good plot for a movie. Yet somehow they messed it up.
I personally, for the plot, I thought it was fine. It's kind of a mishmash of some movies we've already seen, like Godzilla vs. the Smog Monster, and the original Godzilla vs. Mothra from 1964. It treads a lot of the same grounds, but done in a more updated setting. And they rename some of the people, like now the fairies are the Cosmos in this one.
And that's another thing. How did they mess that up? How did they even get uglier twins than the last time? Last time the twins were decent looking. This movie, they're just fudging.
I think they look fine. I actually think they're hot. You're just picky.
Maybe I am, just because of this Mothra movie.
He's like, they weren't singing enough for me, so I don't know.
No, no. You're like, Mothra! I was like, God, mute.
That's how we get Mothra in the cocoon somehow. Because then we gotta get full-fledged Mothra.
Mute.
But there isn't really a whole lot to really gravitate towards the plot-wise, because again... We've seen a lot of it already.
Humans are bad guys.
Humans are bad guys. We should stop polluting. Blah, 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 blah. People stealing Mothra. We shouldn't steal Mothra.
Well, you know, when you think about it, we are the bad guys.
Who was really the bad guy in this movie? It wasn't Godzilla.
Yeah, yeah. we're the bad guys. We're polluting. We're stealing. It's our fault a meteor fell and woke up Godzilla, so that's our fault too.
Though I do admit, I do like the human characters a little bit more in this one than some of the other ones, except for, I'd say, Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah. Like, I like the whole exploration scenes where they're actually on the island trying to find the egg, and then they mysteriously find the cave behind the waterfall, which they find the paintings, which they find a light in the wall that, for some odd reason, even though time passes, like a minute... The light goes all the way up the wall, even though the sun wouldn't have rose that high yet.
But I like that guy, the main character.
Oh, he was cool. He's like a thief.
Yeah.
He's a little bit of a playboy.
He's like, he has that watch, and he's like, oh man, I know where we're at. Or especially like that scene at the beginning when he's running away from certain things. The guy goes through all this hell just to end up at the other end of the gun. He's like, ah, shit.
Yep. And then he ends up in jail. That's pretty much how the plot gets rolling, is they're like, hey, we'll get you out of jail if you go find out what this thing is for us.
He's like, I'd rather spend 7 days in jail. She's like, nah, that's 15 years. He's like
wait, whoa, whoa, whoa. It's also kind of cool to see more, I guess, villain-esque monsters in one movie. Because really, the only truly good monster in this entire movie is Mothra. Because Mothra wants to save the Earth, wants to save people. Bachelor wants to save the Earth. doesn't really care about people, so Batra will go around destroying everybody. And then Godzilla's just kind of doing what he does. So he's still kind of considered a bad guy in this film, too. So then Batra, like, fights Godzilla in this, so you get Mothra fighting Batra, because they don't like each other. But then stuff happens, and then they're fighting Godzilla, as you can assume will happen. So yeah, for the plot, I still enjoyed the movie.
It was okay.
Eh, nothing special. Like, it's probably the weakest in terms of plot of the Heisei series. But some of the things I do like in this movie are the suits, which for Godzilla, pretty much the same as what we got with the last movie.
God, there's so not really many whole suits lot different. In this one.
You also have Mothra, which you have the two versions. You have the larva, which is pretty standard looking. It's not too much different than what we've seen in, let's say, the 64. It's just more of a cleaner look.
Yeah, at least I didn't see the wheels this time, so.
And then we get Mothra, which is my personal favorite of all the Mothras, other than you get the variants like, say, Aqua Mothra or Armor Mothra, I think's a little bit cooler. But for the most part, for just standard Mothras, this is my favorite design. Because I just really like the colors. It's very visually striking. And it's also pretty much what the Treadmaster one was molded after, which is like one of my favorite Mothra toys.
The huge one?
There's a huge one. I got the standard ones. Like, I still have one in the box.
Man, Steve, you need to review that and open that.
No!
yeah, you do.
I'll review the one that's not in the box that has a thing shoved with the buttons.
Like me and
I
that,
got it at a garage sale.
Like me and that Godzilla guy had in our conversation. Steve made me open all my toys for reviews. I think it's time about Steve to open all of his.
No, but mine are collectibles. They're just toys. No! But it's cool to see Mothra with a lot of variety in her attacks. Like, it's just not the powder and scratching and calling it a day. Like, she actually has beam moves, which is really cool
She's
to
like,
see. Yes, and it's awesome. But probably the best monster in the movie is Batra, which you have the larva and the adult version, so you get two different versions. Which the larva version is actually my favorite out of the Batra. Like, Mothra larva is just kind of like, eh, whatever. But Batra's like, oh. It's armor plated, it's all colorful.
I didn't understand why it had to evolve into the adult form.
Yeah, when the larva was pretty much the same size as Godzilla, and didn't really seem like Godzilla was hurting it at all, and also has crazy amount of beam moves in the larva form. Like, compared to, like, the larvas, like, the Batra larva definitely seems like it has an upper hand.
Yeah. Like, what was that, like, what was it doing, dumbing down?
Yeah, I feel like when it got into the adult form, that's when, like, everything became fair. And that's how we're ending this movie, is it had to go to the adult form. Which is still really cool. It's pretty much just like a more demonic looking Mothra. But still very visually striking. It has a lot of like blacks, grays, yellows, orange, reds.
But don't forget green.
It doesn't have green initially.
But it will once Godzilla's done with it.
But in the adult form, it has a lot of beam moves as well. Which pretty much, this entire movie is just one big beam fest for the most part. It's pretty much a special effects extravaganza. Which we'll move on to the special effects, which I feel are really cool when the monsters are doing their stuff, like with their special effects, like with all the beams. Like, I like how Godzilla's beam effect kind of sounds a little weird.
Yeah, it's different. This sound.
It's different. I'm not going to say it's bad, but it's weird because it's like, it doesn't have like that kind of sound to it.
He's evolving too, you guys.
The best one's probably when Mothra's doing like her sport, like powder attack, or wing powder attack, and Godzilla's like trying to spray it and it's like reflecting the beams everywhere.
That part was amazing.
That part's actually really cool. But you don't really get a whole lot of, like, I guess, confrontational kind of attacks in this. Like, there's not really a whole lot of, like, hand-to-hand. You get, like, some here and there, which is probably, like, the more visual stuff.
Hand-to-hand? They don't have hands.
They got little, like, legs.
Oh, what are they going to do? Scratch them to death?
Could. That's what they tried to do in the old ones. Yeah. They just used what they got.
Yeah, except this is 92, man.
And they still only have little legs.
Is it sad that when we get to the special effects part, is that when she, Mothra, is flying, it still looks bad like the 68.
Yeah, they don't get better.
No, it
doesn't. It's really hard to do, like, proper flying techniques with, essentially, it's a giant maquette. Or like a puppet, so it's just, yeah. You have the strings hanging out the wings and you flap it without, like, speeding up the footage. Which is what they used to do, like, the 64 to get to, like, look like it's flapping fairly fast. But then it'll look kind of weird, especially if you have it next to Godzilla, so you just kind of have the flutter. Which I thought we saw was still, it looked good to me. Because it doesn't take away from, like, Mothra's whole color scheme and everything, so she still looks really awesome.
Yeah.
And I imagine they're probably going to keep that for the 2018 when Godzilla comes back out, for Godzilla 2 when they do Mothra in that one.
Gotta hope she's CGI. All of it.
I'm pretty sure she's gonna be as hardcore CGI as Godzilla was.
Okay, good. I wanna see some actual wing movements and not just like, I'm flying! I'm flying!
Yeah, get used to it. Doesn't get a whole lot better. Rodan flies like a jet.
Oh, God, really?
We get him next movie. Yay.
But I actually like Rodan.
Rodan's still pretty cool. But where the special effects, like, fail for me anyways, is when they do a lot of the green screen shots, like, with the cosmos. Like, there's one scene in particular where they first find the egg. And, like, the cosmos speak, like, it's Mothra's egg. And everybody turns around, like, the flower's talking. And then they walk out from behind the flower, but they go from being invisible to, like, partway from the flower, and they kind of fade into the shot. And it's very subtle, but it's really noticeable, though.
That was not subtle. That was right in your face. Like, bam, look at this.
Yeah, there's that. And then you have, like, people running away from the fallen buildings, but the fallen buildings just kind of just go over top of them. With them still just running normally. But for special effects, one of my favorite scenes is just pretty much has to do with practical effects. Well, that's when Batcher grabs the Ferris wheel, picks it up, and throws it into Godzilla.
See, this was a part where I really lost interest in. Because that would look so, like, you'd think, like, something as that Ferris wheel will actually knock Godzilla over like that, like, damage him that much. Like, seriously? No, it would not. Godzilla's supposed to be, like, huge, okay? Ferris wheels are not.
If you still get hit with something with enough force, it's going to knock you down. Like, if I whip this across the room and hit you with it, you might fall down if I threw it hard enough.
Okay, let's try.
No, he's special.
I didn't really like the special effects in this movie. That's like one of the biggest downfalls of this movie was that. There's a lot of scenes like when the fairies or the cosmos? Is that what they call it? Cosmos. You know what? Fairies.
I guess like, you guys, like a lot of the random special effects, like, say with the cosmos, is where like it kind of falls flat a little bit. But then again, kind of fell flat in the older movies too, so it's hit and miss.
But I was expecting that in the 60s. I was not expecting that in the 90s, though.
Yeah, but also these movies don't nearly have as much of a budget as Hollywood does.
What are you talking about? The budget was like over $2 million for this movie.
And what was the budget for 2014?
I don't know, like 200.
It had we a don't two. Talk about it.
It had a two in it.
Somewhere.
Yeah.
So in the end, I still really like this movie. For me, it's probably the weakest out of the Heisei series, easily. Compared next to the rest of them, like with Mechagodzilla and stuff. But I still enjoy the movie in the end. It's a nice environmental movie, even though we've seen it in previous Godzilla films. And the same thing, we've seen the Mothra sequences, more or less, in Godzilla 1964. But it still is a nice updated version of the story. And I really like the costumes in this, with Mothra and Batra definitely being probably the best reasons to watch this movie.
I just feel like they're trying to beat this into us, like we're bad people, we're polluting, we're destroying, and you know, stuff like that. It's just, I don't know.
Well, it's kind of cool that we get like different themes for each of the movies.
Yeah.
Because you get like the original one's more like 1954, Violante's kind of like an environmental-ish movie.
Yeah.
But it's more about like the spirit. And then King Ghidorah is a time travel movie. And this one's the environmental movie. And the next one, we get the mech movie.
Okay, so at least we got something to look forward to next movie.
Yeah, we get pretty much the mech movie, we get the sci-fi movie, and then
there's even a sci-fi?
Sweet. I can't wait for that one, actually. That's the one I'm excited about.
But for this one, it's like, it's a hit and miss. It's got its issues, but definitely, like Steve says, it's probably the worst one out of ones we've seen so far. But yeah, it's still dope. You should watch it, definitely.
Yeah, it's still a really cool movie. But what did you guys think of Godzilla and Mothra Battle for Earth? Or Godzilla versus Mothra, whatever you want to call it. Please let us know in the comment section below, and help us defeat those kaijus by hitting that like button, subscribe, become a ranger today, and see you guys in the next video.
Bye-bye.
I get to go open this now.